Okay, let's go ahead and sketch a bicycle rim, a bicycle wheel. I use my road bike and I measure the dimensions of the front wheel. So let's go ahead and sketch it in AutoCAD. Choose metric. Let's change the units from meters to centimeters. Okay. And let's go ahead by sketching a line. Let's start at 0 and 0. Find the 0 and 0 point and zoom in a little bit. So let's make it 3.75 at 180 degrees. Zoom in. Let's go up 1.65. Oops. 1.65 at 90 and 0.3. At 180, and let's go down 2.5 at 90. Okay, let's round off the edges a little bit. Choose tangent radius. Select these two lines and make the radius 0.5. And let's choose the trim command. Select the circle, enter, erase these two. Repeat, select this and this, enter, erase this. And let's do the top as well. Choose start and end direction arc. Start, end, and let's make it 45. We don't need this one anymore. Perfect. So let's use some shortcuts now. Let's use the mirror command. Select the mirror command under modify. Select the object, enter. Ask you to specify the mirror line. Let's make it over here and enter. We just copied the object on the other side. So now let's revolve the object to make it into three-dimensional figure. So choose the revolve command, select the object, enter. Ask you to specify axis of rotation. Axis of rotation is at the bottom, and make it full 360 degrees. Let's choose realistic. And there you go. This is the shaft. This is where the shaft of your wheel goes. Okay, now let's sketch the actual wheel. Let's choose a basic circle. Let's start at 60 and 0. And let's make it 29.5 centimeters. Okay, let's sketch a line in the middle, make it easier for later on. It's starting at 60 and 0, make it 29.5 at 90 degree angle. See how easy it is when you keep everything exact in AutoCAD. Okay, now let's sketch the actual wheel. So this circle is just the base. Let's choose line and make a box 1.9 at 0, 1 at 90, go back 1.9 at 180 and hit C for close. Perfect. Now let's, starting from the center, let's go down 1.8 centimeters. Make a triangle, hit L for line, a shortcut. Perfect, we don't need this one anymore. This one and this one. And actually, we might need one over here. Actually, no. Let's choose again tangent radius. Select these two. And make the radius 0.2 centimeters. Perfect. Trim command. Select the circle, enter. Erase. Repeat. Select these two lines. Enter. Nice. Okay, let's. Now I measure the diameter of the tire. It was 2.2 centimeters. on a road bike, so let's make a circular tire. So the radius needs to be half of it, which is 1.1. And also, let's finish up the rim. Let's use start and radius arc. So start and radius of 1.1. It's exactly the same as the circle. Now just for convenience, let's sketch a line. Choose the all snap command. Let's choose the the center is okay, perfect. Line and make it 1.1 exactly at 90 degrees. Nice. So now we have to combine them and make them perfect. So choose the move command, select the circle, enter, and choose this, align it with this triangle. Perfect alignment. You can erase this now. So now we have to align this part with the circle. Choose the move command, select the whole thing, enter, zoom in a little bit, choose the very bottom edge, go down and align it with this line. Perfect alignment. You can erase this line now, we don't need it anymore. So now we have to rotate this part over here. We have to rotate it at 90 degrees. So let's go into 3D now. Let's move this a little bit. Now we're looking at it. Now we have a three-dimensional picture. Let's choose the 3D rotate command, select this thing, or better yet, we can actually choose the region command and make these drawings into solids. Choose this, enter, and repeat for the bottom. Just make sure to select every part of it. Don't forget the circle. Oops. Region. So we have this. See, even I forgot one side. This side over here. Starting to piss me off. There you go. Now let's rotate it. Choose rotate. Now you have two solids instead of all the lines. Hit enter and you want to rotate around this axis. Choose the axis and just type in 90. Make it perfect. And escape a few times and now you can see how this is rotated at 90 degrees. Okay, so now it's very easy. Just simply choose the sweep option and choose this plus this, enter, and ask you to, now you need to select the path, which is this circle. There you go. Perfect. Now let's make it a little bit colorful so it's easier to separate, to know what exactly is what. Let's choose render and material browser and let's type in rubber and choose black rubber for the tire. Let's type in metal and this is aluminum I believe. Yep, or you can expand, choose only aluminum. Can make it different colors if you want. This is good. Alright, so now we have to align the rim with the shaft. It's very easy. Choose the top and now go back home. Now we just have to rotate the wheel. Select it, enter, axis of rotation, choose the center. Never mind, you have to be in three dimensions. So we'll have a three-dimensional view. 3D rotate. Select enter. Choose the green axis of rotation, 90 degrees. Perfect. Escape. Okay, choose the top so we're perfectly aligned. Choose the move command. Let's rotate a little bit so we can. You have to select both the inside and the outside. Go back to exactly the top. Enter. And now choose the center. Okay, bring it to the center. This is a little bit hard to align. There you go. Okay, this is perfect. Now, from all the lines that I drew, I now know how I have to draw the sticks that connect the wheel to the shaft. So let's select a line. The line needs to be, let's see, let's, you can start anywhere, it doesn't matter. It needs to be 7.8 centimeters, perfectly straight at zero. Okay, and it needs to be starting from the center. It needs to be 27.5 up. Let's make a triangle. L. You don't need these parts anymore. Use, select circle. Make it 0.1 again, 0.1. Choose the sweep option, select the object and the path, repeat, object, enter, path. There you go. Now choose the move command. Select the whole object, enter, and choose this edge, and now bring it and align it with this triangle. Bam! Look, it's perfect on both sides, here and there. And if you go up, it's a pretty good alignment. Not bad. Okay, now we have to make 18 more connecting rods or spikes, I'm not sure what they're called. So let's choose the 3D rotate. Let's go into 3D, select the whole object, 3D rotate, enter, choose the green and 90 degrees. Okay, perfect. Now type in the array command, ARRAY. Select objects, it's this object and the one in the back. Zoom out, go exactly over here, hit enter. Asks you what kind of area would you like. We want to do a polar one. And specify center point of array. It's exactly the center point over here. And there you go, now you have 6. We wanna have 18. So over here it gives you options, type in 18. You can probably put a lot more. There's no point, mine has 18, I think. And there you go, hit enter, and this is your, you can go ahead and paint everything, any color, or make it all aluminum or whatever you prefer, but this is a basic road bike, real size, almost front wheel. Now you can also go ahead and make the shaft over here, just very simple. Go ahead and draw a circle on this here. Make it as big as you want. Choose the press pull. Make anything you want. But this is a basic bicycle wheel.